Hello, my loves. My name is Joe, and today, continuing on our Creatures of Darkness series, we have the Full Game Collection. This collection represents the vampire. So, this collection, absolutely stunning. Again, as All Creatures of Darkness, Five Shadows, the highlighter, and the lip. So, let's jump straight into it, shall we? This collection was our Halloween collection last year, where Sarah and I were the vampires. Insert clip. We loved this collection so much. It was one of our most requested things to bring back. If you followed me, you know that this is one of the collections I speak about all the time. Obviously, throughout the year, we launched many collections, and none have been as sought after as this collection. Again, it's limited to this Halloween, so to avoid disappointment, I would suggest getting it now. It's going to be available until the 31st of October on thecollectivecosmetics.com. Again, as all the Creatures of Darkness, there is three options to buy. You can either get the full collection for $61, you can get the highlighter and lip combo, or you can get the five shadows together. Up to you. Obviously, I'm not going to tell you what to do with your money, but if you want to get it, I'm just letting you know, you've got until Halloween. Just saying. We'll start with the five shadows. The mat. We've got King. This is such a stunning purple colour. It runs cool. This was one of those colours that throughout the year I just wanted to bring back so much, and I thought I can't do that because then I have to bring back them all. I don't want to bring them all because it's a Halloween exclusive. And if you've seen the Area 51 video, you would have seen that Roswell, the shadow release for that, was inspired by King. Obviously, they're different tonally. This is more cool. Roswell was a bit more darker, and it ran a little bit warmer. It's just the perfect purple matte shadow. It's grounded. The colour of it isn't, it's like not like a neon, it's a very grounded colour. Either to wear this alone or to like use it in conjunction with your other palettes and your other shadows. The amount of looks you can create with a shadow is amazing. It's so versatile and it's just adorable. One of my favourite colours we've ever made, period. Then up next we have, did I call that King? We've got King. Yeah, it's called King. Up next we have Springhill. This is from a Liverpool legend. Obviously I am from Liverpool in the UK.
I am technically from Belfast. Live in Liverpool though, so go off sis.
Springhill was said to be a demonic creature that jumped from rooftop to rooftop adopting little children.
You never abducted anyone?
And we love a little urgent legend. Springhill, this is fall in an eyeshadow. It is the most stunning burnt orange colour. It's just, look at just, I adore this colour so much. It is fall in an eyeshadow. This colour is just either to put it all over alone. It works so well with so many other colours. This colour is one of those staples in every collection. As you know, we have Tune, which was in the Mandela Effect eyeshadow palette. Rest in peace. That was like a bold, bright orange. This one's definitely more dark, it's grungy. It's fall. It's the colour of the leaves falling to the ground. It's absolutely stunning fall. It's autumn. Next we have Dejenny is a green with a shimmer. Now Dejenny is so perfect. As you can see, these colours just scream Halloween green shimmer, but the shimmer isn't like screaming at you. It's far more of a grounded base than like those blackened greenish colours with those lovely green specks just running through it that like just catch the light. It has that dual capability of working as both like a matte setting and as a shimmer, which I have used both as both and can sit now and vouch that yeah, it does both. And then we have this color, Scream Aubergine. Scream Aubergine is a fan favorite by far. This color is just, oh, what you see. This color is so perfect. It's an aubergine shadow. It's got purple, but it reflects a blue. It's got that sort of duochrome kind of effect where in the certain lighting, you'll see a very true purple, then there's bits of blue. And then through it is this gorgeous sparkle. It's like a orangey kind of, orangey purple shimmer, if that makes sense. It's just a stud, you can see it. And then, different from last year, is Apparition. Apparition was one of our highlighters we released last year. This year we have downsized it into a shadow so that we could again have the five shadows to match up with the Creatures of Darkness collections, as all the other collections have five shadows, a highlight and a lip. Apparition is different from the other colours because it was originally a highlighter formula. So you see, it's definitely got that highlight effect. It's there, but this colour on the lid, this got like a rosy base, but the most gorgeous blue reflect. Just, I love this colour so much, and I just wish this camera would do it justice, and I know it is not going to, no matter what I do. Absolutely adore Apparition. Which, obviously, speaking of highlighters, brings me to the next one. Of course, as always, the highlighters come in our trusty compact. There we go. Starday, you know. Good. Hello? Let me just cover my whole hand in a chill. Look at that. That just looks like glass. It is absolutely stunning.
It's just like my t-shirt. Check the skeleton. Can you see it? Okay. This is not the Tookie show. This is the Joe show. What I was going to say is, the next time I say the word stunning, very annoying. Drinking game.
It's got a golden green reflect through it, and whenever we were creating this product, we were thinking of morgues, that Halloween-y, like the medical green sterile, that kind of idea, and then like the ghostly moonlit like effect thing, and that's what we ended up with, moonlit morgue.
I promise this is the last time we pop up, but I've literally just described what moonlit is and what a morgue is. That was rather redundant of me, wasn't it now? Okay, Joe, take it away. Promise this is the same, you'll see me. Bye.
And it is absolutely stunning. It is one of both Sarah and I's most used highlighters from the brand. We just adore it. It's one of those highlighters that we think shows what we are as a brand. It's classic beauty, it's everyday, but then it's got that little edge that, like, you know, a little, you know, that kind of, you know, that kind of, thing.
What?
We are so proud of this colour, and we're so happy that it is back. And then the lip formula, again, this has had a little bit of a change from last year. Last year, Oblivion was in an eye and lip lacquer formula, and this year, which is still available on the site now, if you wanted to pick that up, you most certainly can. But this year we wanted to match the other collections and release Oblivion as a liquid lip. The pure black. Like, hello? You want a black lip that's going to stay put, not bleed, longevity and wear? Oblivion liquid lip, available in the Fall For You collection, also available in the bundle with the highlight. For the looks that me and Sarah done for this, which you're going to see a tutorial on mine in a second. Last year we really played up the colours we want for those bold, bright. And this year we just wanted to have fun. And the reason why we created the Collective Cosmetics is because we love makeup. We love playing with makeup. And especially for the Creatures of Darkness, it's at the heart of what the Collective is. It's two best friends just having fun with makeup and sharing that with the world. So I am going to jump now to the tutorial and I shall see you in a second. I'm so proud of her. That is the Fall Frost Collections, my love. Thank you so much, and I'll see you on the next one.